Hello students, welcome to another lecture that is on the first chapter introduction. In this, the chapter that we are learning is the electric drivetrains. Right, until now we have seen all the things about the hybrid vehicle drivetrains. We saw about the parallel configuration, series configuration, the combination of it, the complex configuration. Right, we also saw how the power is being controlled, the flow is being controlled in the case of the hybrid vehicle drivetrains. In this we will see about the electric drivetrains, right, the electric drivetrains and electrical drivetrain topologies. Right, the power flow control will not be here because in this we are only using one source, that is a battery, right, or we can say the electric source that we will use for the electric vehicle, as we all know. So the topologies will be there, the different arrangement or different configuration, we can see the topologies of the electrical drivetrain, the different architecture of the electrical drivetrains will also be there in this video. So let's start our lecture, that is on the electric drivetrain. The first thing is the concept of the electric vehicle drivetrain. Right, in this you can see a simple schematic diagram with the number of components that you can see here. The electric system can mainly be transmitted in three parts. The first part is the electric propulsion system, which is used to propel the power which is being generated from the battery. Second thing is the energy source subsystem. You can see in the below part the energy storage subsystem, in which the energy is being stored or the charger is used to create the energy in the battery. So in that part the energy is being stored. And the last system is the auxiliary subsystem. Now in the case of the auxiliary subsystem, the system such as power steering, temperature control system, all these things will be used in the case of the systems for the auxiliary subsystems. You can see that the power steering system, or we can see that the temperature control system, the different temperatures of the different components will be controlled with the help of the temperature control system. So these are the three things. First is energy storage, second is electric propulsion, and the third one is the auxiliary subsystem. These three are the systems which create our electric vehicle. First, we can say that the energy is being charged with the help of the charger, and that is stored in an energy source. Mainly the battery will be used as the energy source in the case of the electric vehicle. That energy source is further connected towards the left side, you can see in the figure, that is energy management system. The battery management system will be required whenever we are using the number of battery packs to supply the electric energy whenever it is required. That energy source is further connected in the bidirectional manner. You can say that the arrow is in the bidirectional with power converter, which means the energy source, that is our battery, that will supply the power to the power converter, and also when there is an extra power, the power converter will supply the power in the reverse direction to our battery for the charging. That power converter is first connected with electric controller, right? It will control the amount of the power that needs to be transferred to our electric motor, right? That will be controlled by the electric controller. The electric motor, which is been connected with our power converter, will get the power from the in the form of electricity. The motor will rotate, and that rotation or that power is further transmitted to our mechanical transmission system, which is generally a differential system, or we can say the clutch gearbox system, or we can say the fixed gearing system. There are different types of method that can be used for our electric vehicle depending on the usage. And that mechanical transmission is further connected with our axle, and that axle is connected with our wheels. Right, that electronic controller part will further be connected with our accelerator and brake. Whenever the accelerator is applied, the signal will go to the electric controller, and that controller will control the amount of the battery current that needs to be transmitted from the power converter to our electric motor. So this is simply how the system works. There are no mechanical linkages in this system. The linkages that we are connecting are almost all the electrical system. The mechanical linkage will only come after electric motor, where we have converted our electric energy into mechanical energy. And when the mechanical energy is generated, that will be transmitted further to our mechanical transmission system. You can see here the EV drivetrain topologies that is being classified based on the propulsion system. Right, we have only classified the topologies based on the propulsion system in this case. The second case, the classification will be based on the energy storage classification. Right, so based on the propulsion system, right now you can see in this figure is that there are four layouts that you are seeing right now. There are total six layouts. Let's understand this four layouts first. First, the one letter again is used for the different components. C is for the clutch, GB is for the gearbox, D is for the differential, EM is for the electric motor, and FG is for the fixed gearing. So just look at these figures. The first one is the 3A figure, that is EV configuration with clutch, gearbox and differential. So in this, mechanical transmission is as it is what used in with the IC engine. Just the power source is changing, right? So our motor will be connected with clutch, the clutch will be connected with gearbox, and that gearbox will be further connected with our differential, which is the simplest configuration. So in that case, the gearbox will be operated manually, the clutch will be operated manually with the help of the driver as well. In the second configuration, that is figure 3B, that is configuration without clutch and gearbox. So in that case, you can see the motor is transmitting the power to the FG. Now FG is what? It is fixed gearing. One gear pair is provided, which provides the fixed gearing to our electric vehicle continuously. The fixed gear ratio is kept there. We cannot change the gear ratio in that case. So fixed gear is generally used because we can directly connect our speed with the help of electric motor in the case of the electric vehicle. That was not the case in the IC engine. So we do not require any clutch or gearbox in the case of the electric vehicle. So we are replacing the clutch and gearbox with the only simple fixed gearing gear pair, which will further transmit the power to our differential. Now the third configuration, that is figure 3C. In that you can see the configuration with clutch, gearbox and differential that is not used. It is being transversely mounted on the axle. Right, you can see that motor, fixed gearing and differential, all the things are transversely mounted on our axle, which will save the space in our vehicle. The fourth configuration, that is figure 3D, that is configuration with two electric motors. Right, the electric motors in this case are used, which are two. So motors which will individually connected with the both rear wheels, you can see here. And for both the motors, we have connected fixed gearing system with the motor as well. So that fixed gearing system will give us the power which is required during the vehicle driving, and that two motors will be giving the power to our system as well. So these are the normal four topologies. The other two that I was talking about, you can see in this figure. In this arrangement, it will be pretty much complicated, you can see, or it will be hard to understand right now, but we will see that in the detail. That first, you can see that EV configuration with in-wheel motor, right, which means that the motor will be given inside the wheel. There will be two motors, you can see, but that motor will be given inside the motor, right. For that, the fixed gearing will be also given with the wheel system, in-wheel system as well. That will save the very much of the space, and number of components can be properly adjusted with the help of this, and the power will be properly transmitted directly to our wheels. And the last configuration that you can see, figure 3F, that is EV configuration with inbuilt motor and no fixed gearing. Right? No mechanical gear or no fixed gearing is being given in this system. Only motor is connected inside the wheel. The outer rotor motor will be connected inside the wheel, and for the controlling of the power in the system, we will be provided with one epicyclic gearbox, or we can say epicyclic gear set for each wheels. That epicyclic gear set will be used for the braking deceleration as well. So that epicyclic gear set will be connected with both the wheels and motor. So no gearing, no other clutch gearbox parts or no differential which are connected in there. If we are talking about the inbuilt motors, or we are talking about the two motors that are used in the last three layouts, that will work as the differential as well. When the vehicle is turning, the motor will adjust the speed of the left and right wheel, and the turning will be easier with the help of this setup. So with the help of this setup, we are pretty much easily using the vehicle without the differential. Right, so this is simply, you can see in the last three layout, the differential was not there. Right, so in this video we saw about the electric vehicle drivetrain topologies, which is classified based on the propulsion. In the next video we will see about the other topologies, and also we will discuss about the environmental and economic application, or we can say the effect of this electric vehicle and HEVs. Until then, thank you so much.